Our story begins on the forest trail in the far Northwoods, where each year thousands of tourists come to spend time on vacation for some much-needed rest and relaxation. For some of them, however, the Northwoods is an eye-opening experience where city dwellers and suburbanites encounter the wild kingdom. Walking the forest trail can be dangerous and frightening for the unskilled traveler. The beauty of the forest is deceptive and alluring, but step off the trail and suddenly you can find yourself lost in a cacophony of sounds. Something moves in the thicket nearby, and something growls and hisses. What was that? Is there someone there? Who's following me? There are lakes and streams and hidden valleys and a rich history of Native Americans and explorers that dates back over 1,000 years. Like so many North Country residents, I have a scrap table set up which we affectionately refer to as McNulty's Cafe. It is here that our friends the raccoons arrive looking like tourists themselves and gorging on a variety of smorgasbord delicacies. This little fellow is working hard to get some food. Let's play in the teeter-totter. This corn cob looks mighty tasty. Hey, let's have more pancakes and syrup, please. That's my leftover cheeseburger. Don't eat all those oatmeal cookies. Make room for me. The road to our cabin never ceases to thrill me, and for over 45 years, I have hiked these back trails and winding deer paths. There are many tales to tell here and many years of fine memories. And the forest is indeed populated by a wide variety of interesting characters. Here we see a family of otters sneaking out of the swamp as they make their rounds. The bobcat, of course, is not an animal you should approach. This one was about 30 pounds and struts like a bully on the prowl. Meanwhile, our friends the raccoons are always busy eating and eating and eating. My diet starts today. Meanwhile, at the beach, our slimy neighbor, the northern water snake, is often mistaken for the poisonous water moccasin. This often causes concern among the bleached sunbathers and beer-guzzling suburbanites who are already suffering from sunstroke. Although they are not poisonous, as I mentioned, the northern water snake is still not to be trifled with all the same. Its bite can cause a serious infection. So approach this fellow with extreme caution, or better yet, just leave him alone. He's a clever reptile who enjoys eating frogs and spends far too much time near my pier. Here's a resident we call Wiley. He's a coyote, and the raccoons make a tasty meal if he can catch one. He sniffs about, follows the same trails as the other animals, but mostly keeps to himself. He shows up on my cameras night and day, but he generally behaves himself. My hiking adventures are never boring. There are thousands of glens, clearings, and hidden rivers where I can easily lose myself. When I find a potential good fishing spot, I mark it on my map so I can return later with a fishing pole. Hey, who's that? The deer have suddenly become alert. Even the coyote and the friendly fox are nervous. Who is it that they see? No, not him. Suddenly, the deer bolts for cover. Wait a minute, it can't be. Wiley takes a second look. Some joker in a Halloween costume is trying to scare us. Yeah, well, it's getting crowded around here. Look who's coming now. That's right, the big guy. The true king of the forest himself. He's big, furry, dark, and handsome. Some call him Smokey, some call him Yogi, but I just call him the big guy. He shows up at any time of the night or day that he wants, and he commands our attention. He mugs for the camera and makes himself at home, and he's not always alone. His friends are equally large, furry, and impossible to ignore. They crowd McNulty's cafe like construction workers looking for a good time after work. Sometimes things get rowdy at McNulty's cafe. This charming fellow shows up in my driveway all the time. I'm sure the big guy will agree. When you're visiting the Northwoods, remember, feed the animals and enjoy life. Come on, boys, let's get breakfast.
I'm stuffed.
It's time for a nap. I'd like a bagel and a cup of coffee, please.
Exploring the Northwoods trails quite naturally includes lakes, rivers, and streams, where many an angler has spent an afternoon chasing fish, including yours truly. But those are stories for another day. And so, as night falls on the forest and our friends the raccoons play on the teeter-totter, remember to be kind to each other, and don't forget, you're most certainly not alone.